first a music story to go along with this next topic. You know, there was an update in the Lady A name change this week. Lady A, formerly Lady Antebellum, is now, I believe, countersuing.
Correct.
Lady A, the blues singer. They couldn't reach an agreement. The Seattle-based blues singer, Anita White, who's been using the same name, the country group is suing her, apparently. You know, I think because she demanded $10 million. And they're like, I don't know what else we can do. Lady A, the band, owns Lady A. Like, let's not let that be free. They didn't just go, we're going to be Lady A and we'll take it. They actually owned it and have owned it for a long time. And they were using it a bit. And what's going to benefit them is that they were using Lady A, not just Lady Antebellum. So there's a lot of documentation and pictures and tours and of them using Lady A. So from what I know, and it's tough for me because I am biased here, because I just know them, that there was an offer of some money. I didn't hear this from them.
Okay.
And a duet, even. But then, from what I hear from my sources, they were shocked when she came back and said, no, we demand a $10 million payment. And they're like, well, we own the name already. We're not going to pay you $10 million. So we have to now legally go in this direction to settle it. They don't want to sue it. Nope. They don't want to be a part of any of this. And if they didn't already own the Lady A name, I don't think they would have ever even tried to get Lady A. I think they felt like, we've been going by Lady A some. We own it. I think she mostly has been a local singer up in the area. I was looking at her streams. Regardless, I think in the end, which I predicted from the very beginning, they're going to have to pay her something. I did predict the duet thing too, but I don't think it's going to happen.
Maybe not.
I don't think that, yeah. And I think this will be resolved. I think she probably has an attorney. This is all me speculating, going, demand the world and we'll settle for, you know, a country. You know, reach for the stars and be happy when you land in the clouds kind of thing. I know they're taking it on the chin a little bit, the band member, but when someone demands $10 million, what are you supposed to do? You don't give them $10 million if you don't think it's worth it. It's not worth it. And they owned it already. But she's also been performing by it for a long time. So there's some weird thing. Maybe they both go by it. I would assume that they'll pay her something. Probably, I'm just going to throw a number out here. $400,000 to $500,000. I would assume that's kind of where it's settled. This will be settled. Went to law school for a long time, yeah. 0 days. The band has been using the name Lady A, along with their original band name, since 2006. So 14 years.
Mm-hmm.
So again, it's not like they're just going, we now want to take all rights to Lady A. They've been going by Lady A already. I guess maybe if they had known about her, they would have stopped her a lot earlier. You know?
Yeah.
I don't think anyone is right or wrong. I think they both... But she's been using the name for a long time. She definitely has an argument. They both do. But the $10 million thing just seems a little aggressive.
Yeah.
But I also understand, let's just go ahead and... Because I've done it in contract negotiations. Let me just ask for everything. I don't want it to be called iHeart. I want it to be called iBobby Media. And of course, they're going to say no to that.
Well, but give me this.
But then, yes. So, I'm not inside. I haven't spoken to either three of the band members in the past week. And this has all happened in the past week.
Mm-hmm.
Lady A became an official trademark for the band after 2011. No one filed in opposition to that name. Prior to 2020, she did not challenge in any way. So now it's a challenge. So legally, they've had it, but I do think that she's been performing. There's just something. There's just got to be a middle ground. I'm Mr. Compromise. I always am. Don't you think so?
Yeah.
They're going to have to go out of pocket a little bit. But they're not going to go out $10
million. Not $10
million. The lawsuit does note that White has identified as Lady A since 2010. But the suit pointed out that White's artist page at the time of the court filing had 166 monthly listeners, compared to the band's more than 7 million. You know, they owned it and they had the consciousness of it. Mm-hmm. Who knows? There might be 8 other people going by Lady A in other areas. I don't know. But she did have music on Spotify. She absolutely has a case. I'm not saying she doesn't have a case. The name of the band is obviously extremely valuable to two things. One, to lose a name and start over, horribly hard to do. Or two, to go solo or change a band, like start a new band.
Yeah.
You can have the same lead singer. I mean, rarely does that happen. I mean, the first one that pops to my mind is like Bleachers. You okay. know, that's the guitar player bassist from Fun.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but you don't go Bleachers featuring the guy from Fun. You just got to put a new name out there and hope that some people start to connect and, you know, see interviews. It's tough.
Yeah, that drop-off is crazy when you just go solo. Here's a new project.
Yeah, and even just the solo, even your full name,
mm-hmm.
different than the band. Like when Gary LaVox was talking about him going solo in last week's podcast, that's going to be tough for him because mm-hmm. he's not Rascal Flatts, and I don't think most people that aren't medium country music fans are going to know who Gary LaVox is. They're not going to know he's the lead singer. So Dixie Chicks are not Dixie Chicks anymore. They changed their name. They're just going by the Chicks. Do you know that they finally said something about that, right?
Yeah, I saw
that. What'd they say?
Basically that they came up with it when they were so young and it was dumb then and they had no problem changing it.
Quote, "We were literally teenagers when we picked that stupid name. They explain the band name was a subtle reference to the Little Feat song, Dixie Chicken." Can you pull that up?
Let me find it.
I don't even know if I bet you I know it, but I can't act like I'm too cool right now. However, by 2003, they had already soured to the name. We wanted to change it years and years ago. I just wanted to separate myself. Here we go. Let me hear this. So far, I don't have it. Do you?
No.
Can you go to the hook? Just scroll faster. And in that southern moonlight, she sang the song so well. If you be my kids, I'll be your Tennessee man. A little bit. I would like to act cool. Because I used to listen to a lot of classic rock. I don't know, man. I'm not that cool. Dang, I hate me right now. So they said, hey, we want to meet the moment. So they changed their name. How about Prince? Whenever he wasn't Prince anymore, he was that weird symbol. He was the artist formerly known as Prince, but that wasn't even his name. That's just what you had to say because it was that weird symbol, and you couldn't say the weird symbol in words. In 1993, Prince announced he would no longer go by the name Prince, but rather by that weird symbol. It was like a circle, had a stick coming out of it. There was like a hook at the end. It was a whole thing. The name change was a rebellion against his record label at the time, Warner Brothers. When he signed back in 1977, he was a teenager, nailed some songs, Purple Rain, and they owned Prince and all the music, so he was like, I don't want to be a part of the record industry anymore. So he was then that symbol, and that was it. He then changed back. Finally, he was Prince again. He definitely was Prince again before he died.
Yeah, he's Prince.
Yeah. Pearl Jam used to be Mookie Blaylock, who was a basketball player, who's an NBA star. Pearl Jam once played music under the same name as basketball all-star Mookie Blaylock, even naming their debut album 10 after his jersey number. Is that true?
Yeah.
I knew the Mookie Blaylock. I didn't know 10 was named after his basketball jersey number. But when you use a name that already exists, you can't really trademark it or sell merchandise because he kind of owns it. You know, there have been cases, too, where, because they can't stop you from using your real name. For example, I think I've cited this before, and it's what I'm going to do politically or if I have to change radio stations ever. And if, because I think I may own Bobby Bones at this point. Probably do at this point. That's what I used to think I was going to do. In wrestling, in the WWF at the time, the Ultimate Warrior wanted to change and go to the WCW, but they owned Ultimate Warrior, so he changed his name to Ultimate Warrior. And you can't keep someone from using their real name. So I was like, okay, well, that's just my real name now. So we changed it. That's its name. And I always thought, and I guess now I haven't thought about this in radio in so long because I think I own Bobby Bones. that I would just change my name to Bobby Bones, and then I'd go wherever I want and use the name without anybody's going, now you can't, we own that. But I also think politically, if I run, I have to put Bones in, or it's going to be like one of these stories we're talking about here where you change your name.
Like, who is that?
Yeah.
Same guy?
Is it the artist formerly known as? Yeah. So it's going to be my middle name probably. I'm going to have to switch out my middle name. But yeah. So they were Mookie Blaylock. Let's see who else we have here. Simon and Garfunkel used to be Tom and Jerry. They were 15 years old when they started back in the 50s. And just because they didn't have the most marketable names in the world. So Simon and Garfunkel used to be Tom and Jerry. The Verve used to be just Verve. And they added the to the front after a jazz label. I was like, hey, we're going to sue you. I didn't know the was that much of a changer. Did you?
It changes it. I mean, if you're going to like file copyright over it, if you add a the, it's different. Because they were just Verve Records.
And I guess because it wasn't a band.
Yeah.
Because I don't think you could do that with a band. If one band wanted to just add the, like, for example, Rascal Flatts aren't the Rascal Flatts. Mm-hmm. I couldn't go, well, I got you, boys. I'm going to be the Rascal Flatts. Or I'm going to be the Pearl Jam. It had to be because they were doing slightly different things. But, yeah, Verve had to be the Verve. In September 91, Verve signed to Hut Records, and within a year had three number one singles on a UK chart. They put out the record. They got a visit from American Jazz Label. And they were like, you got to change. So then the Verve. That jazz label had to be like, that's all you're going to change it to?
The Verve.
But Bittersweet Symphony, like as an emo 90s kid, this was my jam. It's a bittersweet. And then they played this at the end of the... Sarah Michelle Gellar, Cruel Intentions.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it was. The other song from Cruel Intentions that was pretty good, but I'm a Counting Crows fan, was I Am Color Blind. Mm. Coffee, black, and tongue-tied. Like, for a second, Counting Crows was cool to everybody, not just to me. Because I love, one of my favorite bands ever is Counting Crows. Because again, their BPM's like one. Slow songs. I am colorblind. He shaved his head. I saw a picture recently. He did. I think he's wearing a wig anyway. Adam Duritz. Do you know what his hair looks like?
Yeah, I haven't seen him recently.
Sugar Ray used to be Shrinky Dinks. They originally called themselves the Shrinky Dinks and later Shrinky Dinks with an X. After the Oven Heated Children's Arts and Crafts Kit. I don't know the Shrinky Dinks. Do you?
You don't remember those?
Mm-mm.
You would like, it's kind of like Play-Doh, but like thinner, and then you would put them in the oven and they would like shrink and make these little like creature things.
Then were they stuck shrunk?
Yeah.
Oh. Once the group got popular, they got a deal with Atlantic Records in 94. The band name obviously got the attention of Milton Bradley, who owned Shrinky Dinks, and they're like, hey, we're going to sue. So then they renamed themselves for the boxer Sugar Ray Robinson, who at that point was dead. You know, probably not going to make the list because they weren't that famous, but Green Jello, the punk band, now Green Jelly.
Mm.
Do you know about them?
I don't know.
We may have you search that out. Throw up some, I guess I out-punked you here, huh?
Green Jello.
Well, it used to be their name, Green Jello, but then they got sued by Jello. Now they're Green Jelly. Do you see Green Jelly?
I do. Three Little Pigs?
Yeah. This is a big song.
Let's see.
Way back in the day. Why don't you sit right back? And I may tell you a tale of three little pigs and a big bad wolf. This was like their one mainstream-ish song. Hit another one, like a random one.
Right, here's the beer song.
Okay, it's got a little more of a punk vibe than the other one does.
Okay, this one was in Dumb and Dumber, I remember that.
Was it?
Yeah.
Well, they had to change their name. They were Green Jello, and then Jello sued. So now they're Green Jelly. Blink-182 used to be Blink. The name Blink was thought up by Tom DeLonge when the band consisted of Tom, Mark, and their friend Scott, which before Blink they called themselves Duct Tape. They were forced to change it because an Irish electronica artist was already using the name, so they just added 182 to the end. Why 182? It's because that's how many times Al Pacino says the F word in Scarface. The Weeknd used to be The Weeknd. Now, what I mean by that is now he's The Weeknd with no E in end. It's The Weeknd. But he used to be The Weeknd. But he had to lose the E due to possible legal trouble from another band called The Weeknd. Again, I don't think that's enough of a movement, just pulling one letter out of it. You like The Weeknd?
I do like The Weeknd. I like the new stuff, too.
The members of the Beach Boys once sued former Beach Boy Al Jardine to stop using the Beach Boys' name. They also sued him for using the names Al Jardine of the Beach Boys, the Beach Boys' family and friends, Beach Boys' family and friends, the Beach Boys' family and friends, the Beach Boys' family. They basically said, hey, dude, stop saying the Beach Boys.
You're not the Beach Boys.
The court held that he could use his former band's name, and mostly it was that he used to be a part of it, right? Mm-hmm. Not that he's still the main Beach Boy. Is that kind of where it settled in that one? Some of his promotional materials displayed the Beach Boys more prominently than family and friends, and they said, hey, like, this is how people know him. And so they also said, hey, people can't differentiate between Mike Love, who was the lead singer, and Al Jardine. Like, there's not one guy who people just see as the Beach Boy.
Yeah.
That all of them are kind of the Beach Boys. And I think most people wouldn't know the difference.
Yeah.
You just go, and if one of the, you wouldn't even know which one it was. Just four old dudes, and you'd be like, one of them used to be a Beach Boy, but I'm going to listen to Surf Safari.
I watched the Temptations, like a biopic. And that happened a lot with them, too, because they just split off and they were all doing different versions of the Temptations.
Really?
So they, didn't really know what version they were going to go see.
Yeah, I think there are a few different Beach Boys.
Mm-hmm.
I think one of them played the Ryman recently before Corona. And I think it was the Mike Love version. I think Eddie went and was like, you know, I wasn't sure who was.
You don't know.
Goo Goo Dolls changed from the Sex Maggots. Man, I used to love the Goo Goo Dolls. You know, I still do. I watched them in concert a year ago. They went and they played with Collective Soul. I guess if that makes me what they say, basic white boy. That's me. Bare Naked Ladies, who I love, used to be Free Beer. This was another. They had 1 week, and this was another song that I learned every word to and was pretty proud of, much like Charlie Daniels we talked about earlier in the podcast. They were originally called Free Beer because it helped them draw crowds when playing the bar scene. Hilarious. The bar owners forced them to change their name because customers were getting angry because they thought it was free beer. So, again, Bare Naked Ladies, still a bit of false advertising. But isn't that funny? Free beer.
Free beer.
Once, when Eddie and I did our first comedy record, which is just okay, not even that good. We had some songs that did okay, but overall wasn't that good. It was called The Critics Give It 5 Stars because I wanted people to see that and think that it was such a good record. And I thought that was pretty funny. Whatever.
It's like the Adam Sandler thing, too.
What was Adam Sandler?
His comedy special. It was 100% fresh.
What? 100% fresh? Yeah. He stole that from me. Randy Travis used to be Randy Trawick. People had a hard time spelling Trawick. Billy Ray Cyrus was set to become just Cyrus in 2017. He said, hey, I'll be just the artist formerly known as Billy Ray. So I don't see, is he Cyrus, though, now?
He still has, Billy Ray Cyrus and all this stuff, but, on his albums, he'll put Cyrus bigger and then Billy Ray really small.
Guns N' Roses was put together from two bands, L.A. Guns and Hollywood Rose. L.A. Guns was kind of famous, though. Katy Perry used to be Catherine Hudson as a Christian artist. She was born October 1984 as Catherine Elizabeth Hudson. And then the Kate Hudson thing got her. She was like, I think people are going to think I'm Kate Hudson. So she was Katy Perry. She was Catherine Perry, then Katy Perry, which was her mother's maiden name. So all those folks had to change. And then I taught you a little something today with Green Jello.
Yeah.
Which is now Green Jelly because jelly is universal. All right, there you go. Let's take a quick break, and then we'll do this week's issue, this week's edition of Super Easy Trivia with Chase Rice, Charles Esten, and Taylor Lewan from the Tennessee Titans. All right, here you go. Hey guys, it's Bobby Bones. Welcome to the channel. If you're new to the channel, subscribe and then go check it out. A lot of artists, a lot of songwriters, a lot of music. Welcome to the BobbyCast channel.